In this video, we are going to talk through some of the more basic functions of Mathematica that might help us when we're working on abstract algebra. I'm going to first show you how to solve a problem in Mathematica, but then I'm also going to show you how to solve the same problem in Excel. That way you have your choice of various options. Whatever you feel more comfortable with, you're free to use for class. So I'm going to do the silly thing first. I'm just going to warm up Mathematica. It's working pretty well today, so I warmed it up. But let's go ahead and let's figure out how we should do something. So the problem that we're going to look at today is what all the different squares are when I mod out by 11. So that's what I want to do. I want to look at some numbers. I want to look at them modulo some other number. And what I'm going to work on today is I want to look at the squares of all the different numbers when we look at them mod 11. So here's what I'm going to do. The first thing I'm going to do, just for ease, it's not necessary, but I want to show it to you, is I'm going to create a function. So I want to create the squaring function, f of x is equal to x squared, and the notation for doing that in Mathematica is, I'm going to name my function, I want to just call it f. It's going to be a function, so Mathematica uses square brackets for arguments of functions. And it's going to take in a variable. So the syntax for this in Mathematica is to indicate what variable it's going to take in by putting the letter followed immediately by an underscore. So I want to create a function. I want to call my function f. It's going to be a function of the variable x. And because I'm making a definition, Mathematica requires a defined equal sign here. Notice how it just changed the color and the formatting of everything. It now knows that I'm making a definition. And what f of x is it's really x squared. And that's the whole function. And I'm done defining it, so I hit shift enter for Mathematica to register that function. Now, this would be the function that I would be interested in looking at, but I'm not truly interested in this function. I'm only interested in the values of this function when I mod out by 11. So I don't really want to see x squared. What I want to see is x squared modulo 11. Or the command in Mathematica for modding is just the mod function. So suppose that I wanted to look at what happens when I take 9 and square it modulo 11. One thing I could do is say, let's take f of 11, so it says take 11 and, f of 9, take 9 and square it, and let's look at that answer, modulo 11. So this is the syntax of the mod function. It takes in two arguments. It takes in the thing that you want modded, and then it takes in the modulus second. So I want to look at 9 squared modulo 11, and I ask Mathematica to compute it, and Mathematica tells me 4. So this is one option. Another option is to just build the modulus into the function f. So instead of defining f the way I have, another option is I could take f and define it to be a function of two variables. It takes in two things. It takes in an x, and it also takes in an n. Now when I call the function f, it'll operate just like the mod function. And what does it do? It takes x and it squares it. But it looks at that answer, modulo whatever number I pass in for the second parameter. And this is my new function that is really x squared modulo n, and I have the liberty to change the divisors that I need here. Now if I ask it for f of 9 comma 11, it'll give me the same answer as it did when I used this other syntax up here, 4. So both of those are options for if you want to define functions using the mod function. Do you want to mod by yourself when you're typing things in later, or do you want to build modding right into the function? I think I prefer the second option because it gives me the liberty to change things. Now I could look at f of 9, but I could look at that modulo 10 all of a sudden, and now it gives me the other correct answer. So let's continue on. Now, we said that the goal of this problem is to look at all of the squares that we could have if we take numbers and square them and then mod them by 11. What I want is I want to do one process and I want to do it over and over again. So I guess one option that I had would be say, tell me f of 0, 11. Tell me f of 1, 11. And it could tell me these things one at a time, but if I wanted to tell me these things all at once, I can use a table. So what do I want to make a table of? I want it to display for me f of x, 11, so 11 is my modulus this time, That's what I want it to display. And then the next thing that I need to enter for the table is, first of all, what's my variable? My variable is x. And where do I want it to start looking at x values, and where do I want it to stop? So since I'm working mod 11, I want to start at 0, but I only want to look at things up through 10. Those are the only numbers in the world I care about when I'm working module 11, is the numbers that come before it. So I want to start at 0, my first example, and I want to stop at 10. And when I hit enter here on the screen, it will tell me 0 is f of 0, mod 11. 1 is f of 1, mod 11. 4 is f of 2, mod 11. And it goes on this way. The very last thing that I might want to do is, it's possible that I would be looking at a really long list, and I want to know, okay, it's fine for 0, 1, 4, and 9. I can figure out that comes from 0, 1, 2, and 3. But here are 5. This is where I start hitting, like, unintuitive answers. What 5 really is the answer to what's 4 squared modulo 11. And so maybe I want to list the value of x first, and then the value that its square takes on module 11 second. And there's a way to do this in the table as well, which is to say, in the table, I don't just want f of x 11. I do want that, but I want something else. The first thing I want you to put is x, followed by f of x, 11. So tell me the number before you tell me what its square is, and then do the same thing. X is ranging from 0 to 10. Now hit enter, and it'll give me a list of pairs. 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9, but it'll also tell me that 4, when I square it, has this answer of 5 as a remainder. And this is the basics of all I really wanted to show you here in Mathematica today. Those handful of tricks will take you very far for your next assignment. But let me show you how to do this in Excel also. So let's open up Excel. And let's figure out the same problem. We want to look at squares of things, modulo 11. Excel uses almost exactly the same command as Mathematica and the same formatting, just written in sort of Excel function type syntax. So, the mod function in Excel, when you're defining a formula for a cell in Excel, you have to hit an equals first. You're saying, I'm defining this to be something. And then you use mod for the mod function. And just like in Mathematica, it takes in two parameters. The first thing it takes in is the number that you want to look at, modulo something. So it even tells you number divisor right here. First thing you want to put in is number, the second thing you want to put in is divisor. So that would be our formatting for the mod function. Let's put something in so it has something to mod. Let's just create a list of numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3. We want to go up to 10. Excel, I could just enter that by hand, but Excel is really good at pattern matching, so I can just put that there and drag it down. Numbers 0 up through 10. And what I want to put over here in column B is I want to put the squares of each of these numbers, but not just the squares modulo 11. The command is basically the same, equals mod. And what do I want to mod? I want to take this number and multiply it by this number and mod it by 11. That's what it means to square something. It gives me that answer of 0 here. And the great thing again about Excel is I don't have to remember as much formatting now. Excel is really good at patterns. So if I take this cell now and drag it all the way down, Excel understands the pattern perfectly. And it gives me the squares, much like we were seeing in Mathematica. 0 squared is 0, 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4, that's great, but we hit 4, where the first interesting thing happens, and we square it, and we get 16, and we mod it by 11, so we end up with 5. And the nice benefit of doing this in Excel is I didn't have to be quite as good with programming. Excel could kind of catch on to the pattern that I wanted to repeat, and it lists them side by side already, so I don't have to add that level of futzing around in Excel. Maybe not as pretty, but certainly works just as well, and you're free to use whatever method helps you with your work.